Polly Popcorn, Polly Popcorn, do you rent or do you buy? He's the guy that will tell you why. Polly Popcorn at the movies. Hey, that's me. Hello, my fellow filmigos, it's me, Polly Popcorn, and I got Carmela DeCorno, the toughest movie critic on the streets, and we're with filmigos.com. And of course, we got with us today our blogger punching bag, David, the amateur movie blogger. David, why don't you say hello?
Hi, everyone. And Polly, thank you for having me back on your show again. And thank you, Carmela, for not burning me too badly, since apparently now you can breathe fire. And in case you're wondering what we're talking about, go ahead and check out our previous review of Godzilla.
Oh yeah, that review was a real scorcher. Speaking of which, our review today is with X-Men Days of Future Past. And basically, it's set in the future where all the mutants are being hunted down by these giant robots called Sentinels, and they're put into slave camps or put to death. And what happens is that there's a few X-Men left over, led by Professor X and Magneto. And it also includes such classics as Wolverine and Iceman and a couple other people. And what they do in a typical, time movie, they send Wolverine back into time to try and stop the point where the alternate, future happens. So he's got to go back and try to save the future. It's kind of like a Marty McFly type thing. Anyways, David, what did you give this movie?
Okay, sounds good to me. Here's my top three reasons why I give it a rent. Number one, action, or pretty much a lack thereof. I was hoping for a little bit more, especially since we had, some of the characters from the X-Men First Class series and the previous X-Men trilogy. I was really hoping to see more of them get together and do some like really cool action sequences. And there's a few, and they're pretty good, but I was expecting more. Which brings me to point number two. Since there was a lack in action, there was also a lag in some of the momentum of the movie as well, which kind of caused a two-hour film to feel more towards a three-hour film, but not too bad. And number three, Quicksilver. Man, this is like the coolest character in this whole story, and I kind of wish they used him some more, especially since in that one scene, you guys are absolutely going to love it. And that's why I give this movie a rent.
Carmela, come on. You know what to do. Take care of this.
Your reviews suck, bub.
I didn't know Wolverine had a dog. I didn't know that dog looked like you. Anyways, that's what David gets. So, X-Men Days of Future Past. I liked it. Heck, if you saw all the other X-Men movies in the theater, you should go and see this one. It definitely replaces that crap fest that it's X-Men number 3, was it The Last Stand? Forget about that one. Anyways, go and see this movie because I give it a theater. Well, ow!